Hello everyone. So we're starting chapter 3. Chapter 3 talks about adjusting entries. And so in chapter 3 videos, we'll talk about why do we have to do adjustments, what's the purpose for that, and then we'll see how the journal entries for adjustments will look like. But before we start that, we have to talk about the difference between cash accounting, cash basis accounting, and accrual basis accounting. Now, usually, any accounting system, it has to be based on accrual. But some companies, for some reason, they prefer the cash basis, which is for taxation, for official presentation of accounting financial statements. It has to be based on accrual, even if some companies choose to do the cash basis. So cash basis accounting, it means companies will record revenues and expenses when they pay for them or when they receive cash for them. So revenue will only be recorded when they get cash for that, and then expenses will only be recorded when they pay for it. But the accrual basis accounting, it's not based on cash, it's based on accrual. What accrual means, it means when revenue and expenses, they happen. So two main principles in terms of accrual accounting. The first one is the revenue recognition principle, which means that revenue is normally being recognized when it's earned, not when we get paid for it, okay? When it's earned. So if I provide a service today and I finish it, it's done. I have to record a journal entry to increase the revenue, even if the customer will pay me in future. Okay, so I do not wait to get the cash before I record the revenue. The other principle, which is related to expenses, it's called the matching principle. And it's kind of the same what I explained about revenue. It's expenses have to be recorded when they incur, not when we pay for them. So let's say that we got a bill today for an electricity bill. It shows that there's a $50 utility bill that has been incurred already for a specific period of time. It's already due for payment. And even we deciding to pay for it sometime in future, today when we get the bill, it's incurred, it's due for payment, we have to record an expense. Now, how do we do that? We do debit expense and credit. Not cash, because we didn't pay for cash, but we will credit accounts payable, okay? So that's what accrual means. It's to record revenues and expenses when they incur, and revenue when it's earned. Okay, now let's focus on the accrual basis. The adjusting entries that we will record in this chapter, the adjusting entries that we will record, those are mainly two types of journals. One of them is the deferral journals or deferral transactions, and the other one is the accrual transactions. The main difference between them, deferral, it's when we get the cash in advance for a service that we will provide in future. That's number one. Number two, it's when we pay for an expense that will incur in future. So we pay money in advance. So deferral, it's cash in advance, either paid or received, and the revenue or expense will be in future. Okay, so cash today, revenue or expense in future. But accrual, it's opposite. The revenue or the expense is today, and the cash is in future. Okay, so for example, the utility bill that incurs today, it has to be recorded as an expense today, but we will pay for it in future. All right. That's the main difference between deferral and accrual. In our next video, we will talk about the journal entries, and we will see the difference between deferral and accrual in terms of journal entries.